recognitions, and we'll start with the student of the month. After the student of the month, we'd encourage you to stay for the entire meeting, but if you do need to leave, we will pause for just a second, and we'll start with the Bloomfield Elementary student of the month.
All right.
If you can, right in front of Darren.
Right in front of Darren. Okay, student of the month for October, I want to call up Avery Canolte. Come on up here, kiddo. You stand on this side, sneaking to you, I don't want to see you more than me, I assure you. Okay, so Avery is a fourth grade student from Miss Medina's class, right?
Yes.
Do you like her much?
Yes, I do.
Okay, all right, good deal. And her father, Jared, is here, he's in the back with the big old long beard going on back there. Her mom is Alicia Nelson, she has a brother, Ian, correct me if I mess up, okay? Quietly, because I don't want anybody to know. Favorite subject is reading, nothing wrong with that. Her hobby, playing with her dog, Clark.
Yes.
Who is a silver lab.
Yes.
All right. And I asked her what her favorite food is, and she said...
Chicken.
Who's chicken? Her dad's chicken. She said her dad's fried chicken is the best.
And
yeah, he'll have to prove it. You're on the spot, Jared. And to kind of prove how good it is, I asked her, I said, what is the craziest food you've eaten? And she responded with, she's a really picky eater. So chicken is about it. She's got to be a connoisseur of chicken, and she thinks his is the best. He must be good, right? You would agree with me. That's what I thought. Favorite color is blue. Favorite movie is Bolt.
Yes.
You're going to have to tell them what that is because I've never seen that movie.
It's a really good movie.
It's a really good movie?
Yeah.
What's it about?
It's about this dog that's trying to save this girl, and he ends up dating her, and a lot of stuff just happens, and it's really hard to explain.
Well, you did better than I did because I haven't seen the movie. Does that work?
Yes.
All right. There you go. So I asked her, I said, what do you like about Bloomfield? She said, the people are very nice here. So congrats to everyone else, because you're making an impression on a young lady. So that's awesome. And then we always put a teacher quote. So Miss Medina says, Avery is an awesome student. She works really hard and asks questions to improve her learning and is kind to all of her classmates. And she is very thankful to be your teacher. And I think it's probably important, though I didn't know this, that Jared told me that she was actually student of the month in second grade. So this is her second time right now. So she's doing something right. She's doing something right. So I'm going to hand this to you. Congratulations. There's your plaque. And we're going to step right here. We're going to get a picture. Okay? All right. Now I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Dean.
Okay, I've got three to recognize. One from October, and I'm going to take care of that, and that is, of course, she was busy at that time to not be able to be here, but that is junior Emma Vaught. So Emma, come on up here, please. What was it, volleyball?
Yeah, volleyball game.
That's right, okay. All right, so when we had our October meeting, Emma was had a volleyball match that night. As I mentioned, though, Emma is a junior. So some questions that I asked and just have them go there. But first off, her favorite food, chicken nuggets, mac and cheese. There they go. And that's a good combination right there. What clubs and teams, programs, or groups are you involved with? Now, I understand Emma's a junior. She's been here, so she's got a lot. And then she is a very involved person. She's a member of the varsity volleyball team, varsity cheer team. Also a member of Unified Track, Beta Club, Student Council, Spanish Club, FTK, which is for the kids, the Riley Children's Hospital, booster club, and a student mentor to two wonderful little girls in the elementary. I can understand that. That is awesome. She loves to hang out with her friends and family when she can, and also loves to watch Netflix. It's a definite high school thing for sure. Her favorite subject, I really enjoy chemistry and love the teacher. She makes learning fun, and that is
Miss Bonner.
That's right. Miss Bonner does do a good job of chemistry. And the last question is, what do you like most about Bloomfield Junior Senior High School? And she says, I like how the class sizes are small. You can have a personal relationship with all of your teachers. I also like all the dual credit opportunities that we have here. It allows me to get college credits out of the way in high school for hardly any cost. Love that. Even if there is, even one. Okay, that is awesome. So, Emma, congratulations.
Thank you.
You're quite welcome. Yes. I'm glad you're going to help me out. Okay, our next student of the month is for eighth grade for October. I'm off a whole month. Emma was September. This is October. Thank you. I'm glad somebody mentioned that to me. Well, I was keep going, right? Our next student of the month is eighth grader Taylor Thompson. Taylor, come on up here, Taylor. Good. Okay, Taylor, her favorite food, Chinese or Italian? She goes even well on that, so she likes that. Let's see. Her favorite partner of her clubs, teams, programs, she is a member of Sea Perch, and that is awesome. They have done so well over the last few years. And who's your sponsor on that?
Miss Rod.
Miss Rod. You like Miss Rod?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, can you understand her? Does she slow down? She has more words in her mouth than anybody, doesn't she? Right. Her hobbies and likes, she enjoys Netflix, friends, Paris, and being at home. All right. Her favorite subject, history and science. I understand that with the Sea Perch. And what she likes most about Bloomfield, my friends, and being a Cardinal. Love that. Love being a Cardinal. Congratulations, Taylor. Good job. All right. And Ms. Quinn, say that our students of the month, they are nominated and then voted on by our teachers, by their teachers. So that is a really high accomplishment with that. So very proud of that. And our third student of the month and our second for October is sophomore Ethan Sue. Get up here, Ethan. So Ethan Suter is a sophomore here at Bloomfield Junior Senior High School. His favorite food, on the spot, what is it?
Pizza.
That's right. His favorite teams, he is a member of the Beta Club, which is very involved in the Junior Senior High School. His hobbies, video games. He's a gamer. His favorite subject is also science and history. So well done there. What's he like most about Bloomfield Junior Senior High School? I like everything about it, he says. So Ethan, well done, buddy. Congratulations.
Congratulations to the students of the month and their families, and we invite you to stay, but if you need to leave, we understand, and we'll pause here for just a second.
Thank you. All right, see you.
Back here?
Yeah, I think so. You want them on podium?
Either way.
A little better.
All right, so I just have a few things here. One, I like to always recognize other students that earn, or that win our drawings for our character trait program. So we got a few of those for the month of October. The character trait this month was courage. So anytime a student displayed courage, then they were given a character ticket, which they could bring to the office, put in a bucket, and then we have a drawing every week. And so they win, they get you know, some candy, they can win tickets to, you know, have lunch with the principal. You know, that's a big thing, regardless of what people think, it's not detention, it's a good thing. Or maybe they want some free time or a little bit extra time outside of recess or something. There's something to encourage them to continue to do the right thing. So other students that did win for this month, Kaylin Clune from Miss Abrams' class, Preston Calloway from Mrs. Pemberton's class, Lelaney Garcia from Mr. Wagner's class, Angela Eisenhower from Mrs. Barker's class, Austin Phillips from Mrs. Neal's class, Jamison Bandy from Mrs. Riggs' class, and also Maggie Lockenauer from Mrs. Riggs' class, and Sadie Talley from Mr. Wagner's class. So all of those won our prizes. We make a big deal out of it. I mean, we bring all the kids out into the hall. We call their name, make it just really ramp it up. They go down the hall and come back with everybody cheering them on, and then to the office where we give them their prizes. So take their pictures. If you come in the building, it's right outside the office. There's a big bulletin board with everybody's pictures and things on it. So it's a big deal. So congratulations to them as well. I'd like to recognize Miss Julie Evans and our makery. You know, we've got the makery thing here. When we were doing the vision screenings, Miss Renee McIntosh went to her to see if she would make the occluders. Is that what they're called? Occluders, which is where they hold them over one eye so they can test the different eyes. And they did that right here. They didn't have to call anybody in. They didn't have to buy them. They made them right here. So just already makery is coming in handy, and there it's positive things right away. So thank you to Miss Evans for doing that, and for Renee for even having the foresight to ask, because it's new to everybody. Fourth and fifth grade students and teachers did their Native American projects. All you need to know about how cool that was is it involved a lot of sticks and a lot of mud. Our custodians weren't so happy, but everyone else thought it was pretty cool. So they had a good time. They displayed those for a few days, let the other classes come around and see them. And then now, what's going on right now is third grade is doing their pumpkin spectacular. Same concept, only they are reading books and they are taking pumpkins and trying to recreate their favorite character in their favorite book and then displaying it for everyone. So that's happening right now through Friday. And then I have a couple thank yous. The Lions Club and Dwayne Hostetler, I guess, they are bringing dictionaries for our fourth graders. So I think 57 dictionaries they are donating to our fourth graders. They were supposed to be here this week, but it kind of got pushed back a little bit, so probably next week is when that's going to happen. And then I was just made aware, last thing I have here, the Women of Worth from the Greene County Foundation have donated $750 to the elementary school for playground equipment. So that was a blessing to have that. And they came to us. I didn't even know it was a thing. They came to us, and then we applied, and I was notified that we were accepted. They are going to award that to us. So that's all I have for now. I'll turn it over to Mr. Dean.
Okay, thank you there, Mr. Riggleman. Just taking care of our recognitions here for October. We had several things that occurred this month. Certainly, some of the things, and I'll just go down through. First off, our boys cross country team were the SWIAC champions. That was back at the beginning of October. Wyatt Fry, Justin Beard, Landon Myers, Lance McIntosh, and CJ Sylvester earned all conference. Actually, Wyatt was the overall winner. We went 1-2-3 with Wyatt, Justin, Landon, and then CJ and Lance went 6-7, I believe, or 5-6. So pretty impressive move there on the conference. Also, the girls' cross-country team, Adeline Wiseman, sophomore, and Jaden Meadis, freshman, also earned all-conference. for their places in the conference meet. The boys' cross-country team then advanced out of the sectional with a third-place finish at B&L, which is pretty, it's not pretty, it is, it's very impressive. And then as a team advanced to the regional, they came up a spot short in the regional, but we did have three that went on to run in the semi-state, and that was Wyatt Fry, Landon Myers, and Justin Beard. As far as the girls, Adeline Weissman and Jaden Metis advanced out of the sectional both, and Adeline advanced on to the semi-state. So a lot of good things there. Our girls volleyball team repeated as sectional champions. That was a three-peat. Unfortunately, they got off to a great start at Morristown last Saturday, but didn't quite fall, you know, just couldn't follow it up there. So didn't make it out as regional champions, but congratulations to Ms. Potts and the girls for their efforts over this season, certainly. Runners up in the conference, and then, like I said, sectional champs. Boys junior high golf, undefeated, SWAC champions. Mr. Weissman, Chad Weissman is their coach, and the boys there had a really good season, enjoyed themselves, had a lot of fun. You know, golf's certainly a game that you can play way up into the years, so it's always good to learn those things. I want to acknowledge the or congratulate our newly inducted beta members for junior high and high school. A little bit different of a ceremony with certainly the COVID-related conditions and so forth. So we had that during the day, and Miss Fowl is our sponsor, and so she took care. And we had the junior high during the junior high lunch and the high school inductees. Those are two large groups. For our school, they do a lot. It's philanthropic. They go out, they several service hours, and have a really good time with the state conference as well. So congratulations to those junior high and high school members. Our boys and girls soccer teams had a successful year. Again, came up short in the sectional, but you know, you're looking at year three for both teams. I know the boys team, I want to say they were four wins, five wins this year. Girls got on the board as well and competed and played real well. So we look forward to them moving on. Boys 10's team had another successful year. They did not repeat as sectional champions, but again, several holes that they had to fill from last year and did well. Our NJROTC had their Cardinal competition this past weekend where they finished second overall. We had teams from Kentucky, Ohio, and Indiana. And Bloomfield finished second behind Floyd Central. Floyd Central is very solid. As far as the ROTC unit, finished in front of New Albany and the teams from Kentucky and Ohio. Two other things here, just real quick. If you walk our hallways, you've probably seen Mr. LeGrand's advanced art mobiles that are hanging in the various areas of the hallways. And the point of that is they have three movable pieces that move independently of each other and all that. And then throughout the year, you'll see Mr. LeGrand's art classes, and I always look forward to the one where they have the whatever their design or their project. It could be, I've seen them going from one floor to the next floor and coming out of one and into another, so it's pretty impressive. And then today, our juniors, we had the PSAT for the juniors today, so all of our juniors took the PSAT, lasted about 4 hours, did a good job with that, and I'll be kind of prepping them ahead for the SAT. So that is what I have.
Thank you.
You go.
All right, the next agenda item is our consent agenda.
Yeah, so board members, you received that, we've got the meeting minutes from September 24th, the treasurer's report, personnel, we have some non-certified, certified, and some coaches to approve for their positions. We had a field trip from ROTC to approve, and then want to recognize some donations for requesting approval. Green County Foundation, these are all for ROTC, for ROTC program. The Green County Foundation, $2,400. Presbyterian Church Women's Group gave $100. Rebecca Skillman gave $100, and Tri Kappa gave $100 for our ROTC. Thank you for our donators for supporting Bloomfield. So we ask motion or request approval for those items.
Okay, we have a recommendation. Do I have a motion to approve? Katie, do I have a second?
I'll second.
Rich, all in favor? Okay. Agenda item four, our reports.
Yes, I asked Kathy Martin to be here today. We have this year, it's a new program, before and after school program. And I won't say anymore. You explain the rest, all right?
Right.
So if I just unplug, just unplug it in line, I'll be good to go. Glasses on so I can see where I'm plugging this in. I'm the director of the 21st Century Community Learning Center Grant Program, and I started June the 1st. This program allowed us to bring a before and after school program to the Bloomfield School District. This grant was written to provide a STEM-based program, which is science, technology, engineering, and math programming to the students that participate in this. We partner with the IU School of Education, Ivy Tech, Crane, and the Greene County General Hospital within the grant. And we're working with others in the community as well in making this program a success. The before school program runs Monday through Friday from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. We hold that in the elementary cafeteria. We don't have a lot of time for actual programming in the before school program. Not to mention that's a fairly early to do a lot of programming for those students. We do have games and activities that we work on at that time. We're up to 13 students in the before school program. I reached out to each of the teachers for the students in that program, letting them know that the students were in there, asking them to send us anything that they could share with us if the students needed to work on anything in particular. We tried the approach of asking the students, you know, do you have anything you need to work on? Is there anything we can help you with? And that didn't go over real well because they were always, oh, no, no, I'm done. So we kind of tried to focus on their spelling words because that's something that we know that they can, everybody can use some help on that. So we have even though we only have 13 students in that part of the program, we have a pretty wide range of grades of students. So everybody has different days that they have spelling tests. So whoever has spelling tests that day, we work on their spelling words. And one student in particular that struggles academically, we've gotten some feedback. You know, the teacher even wrote back to us and said he was usually getting two or three words right on his spelling test, and he's up to getting almost half the words right, which is seven or eight. So it was really good for us to get that feedback that, you know, we're doing some good in that. They are spending a lot of the time in the before school program playing some games, which a lot of those are, you know, educational type games, and they're doing some art activities and those kind of things. But we're providing some help to them in the spelling and some socialization, and that we're doing that we could do, you know, with COVID as much as we can. We transition those students to the breakfast line just before 8 o'clock, and then those students go on to their class in the morning. The after school program and the presentation that I have here, this was actually written by one of the teachers in the after school program, and what she's been doing is taking this to some of the classes in the elementary and using this to help promote the program and to let students know about the after school program. So I thought this was really a good way to kind of explain to everybody else. And there's also some pictures in here of some things that they've been doing. So I kind of wanted to use this because I thought she did a really good job with it. And it just explains a little bit about the after school program. And she did a little background on it. The after school program is a grant given to select schools. Bloomfield was only one of two schools selected this year. It's used to further reach students exploring STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and math. Or you can add the A in there for the arts and make that a STEAM program. We look at skills needed for these areas and talk about and solve problems. The after-school program runs Monday through Thursday every week, and that's any day that school's in session. It's from 3:15 to 5:15, and the students are asked to commit to at least 3 days each week. We have a parent handbook and a registration form that I send out to the students and their parents. And the students and the parents sign that, committing that they will attend 3 days a week. We have homework help, and I'll get into that a little bit more on the next slide, but we do some homework help, but this isn't a homework program. And that's one of the misconceptions that we've kind of had to deal with a little bit, is that people think, oh, we have an after-school program and it's just for tutoring and homework help. This grant was actually written as a to provide STEM programming to the students, but we are actually able to offer some tutoring help in that. But we stress to the parents that, you know, they still are responsible to check the student's homework and to make sure that the student's homework is done. And she even put that in her presentation to the students, just to make sure that they do understand that. We do programming, which we'll get into in this last bullet point here, projects and activity. We have a theme every week that they work on. So this just shows a little bit of their daily schedule. They have a snack. We have the cafeteria provides a snack program. We take attendance and the kids get some time to kind of unwind from the day. Because we start at 3:15, they get out at 3, and we meet at 3:15. And then they have time to work on their homework and have a teacher or assistant to ask questions. We do have, just in the last couple of weeks, we were able to get set up a virtual tutoring program with IU students. And that is for the 7th through 12th grade. And then we're using BETA students to help with tutoring for the K through 6th grade. Most of the younger students don't really need too much tutoring, but the 3rd to 6th grade, some of them need them. So the BETA students have been working out really well to tutor with the younger kids, and then we've got this virtual program. They're using Google Meet. We're dealing with a few technical issues right now, but hopefully we'll get that worked out where they can do that. I think that's going to be extremely helpful. As we deal with the red and white days and more virtual, that the students are going to need more help with homework, and I think that's going to become even more helpful for us in having that help with the homework. In the 4:15 to 5:15 is when we offer that programming, the STEM programming, and I've got some slides that'll show you the things that they've been working on, and then they just pack and clean up. These are some of the things that, some areas that they worked on. This kind of goes by weeks, what they have concentrated on. They started out with Google Drive, Google Docs, and slides, just to kind of reorient the kids to working with those things. They did a segment on cane toads, an invasive species. And kids always like to work with toads, so that was fun. They did microscopes and how to use them, musical instruments, bands, building bridges and stabilizing structures. They did a segment on rocks. And right now they've been working for the last couple of weeks on snap circuits, kits, rovers, and sew circuits. We've been dealing with, Crane has a lending library, and it's not just a library where we get books. We have a lending library where we can actually borrow microscopes, telescopes, rocks. The snap circuits that we're using for this are things that we get from the Crane Lending Library, and they'll even deliver them to us. So it's worked out really well, and valuable things that the kids can actually use that they will just bring to us and let us use. So it's been wonderful to work with. These are some pictures and not real close-up things, but these are some things they did on the segment where they worked on, where they learned about cane toads and the invasive species. Music Week, they built some musical instruments and learned about different types of instruments. During Rock Week, they did borrow some rock, different types of rocks, learned about different types of rocks that they got from Crane Lending Library. Not a good picture, but the snap circuits are extremely, they're really cool to watch and work with those. We had someone come in today from the group that's doing the analytics on our program, And so we got to go in and watch different areas, and it was really interesting to watch them build things with these snap circuits. So it's really cool, the things that they're learning and the things that they're getting to do that I don't know that they would otherwise, you know, necessarily get to do. Some things that they've got planned just now, from now to the end of the year, or to the end of the calendar year, to the end of December, crocheting and blankets. They're going to do a segment on painting, and they're going to do a segment on Native Americans, pilgrims, and Thanksgiving history. So some really cool things that they're working on. We've had to tweak some things and make some changes along the way, but to start with a brand new program with no exposure in the community, no exposure with the parents or anything, and to be where we're at now, I'm really happy with our progress. We're up to 30 students in the after-school program, and as I said, 13 in the morning, so I think we've grown really well. I just sent out an application today, right before I came here, to somebody that had requested one. We got one in today, so we've constantly getting more applications, so I think we really are growing. There's a lot of things that we can still focus on offering that will help build the program. We have science and robotics workshops planned with Ivy Tech. We had some planned this summer that we couldn't do due to COVID. I'm hoping to make up some of those in the spring. I've met with Greene County General Hospital, and they're going to offer CPR and safe sitter programs. When it's safe to do that. I think the safe sitter classes would be great things that we could offer in the spring before the students are out in the summer, before they're going to be doing babysitting jobs in the summer. I'm also hoping to bring in somebody that can work with the junior high and high school students on job skills, interviewing and resume writing, and how to look for jobs. And we can always do things for the younger students about just exposing them to, you know, what different types of jobs are. So I've been blessed with the great staff that that work in the program. They've done a phenomenal job, so a lot of interest in it as well. Overall, I'm really happy with where we're at. I see a lot of potential for growth and expansion, so. Thank you.
Brandy Hyatt, she's the director of Green Sullivan Special Education Cooperative, and just to share about the services the co-op provides for Bloomfield School District. Thanks for being here, Brandy.
Welcome. Thanks for inviting me. I thought I'd introduce you to myself a little bit as the new director here. My career in education started as a paraprofessional in the classroom, and then after spending a year there as a para, I decided to pursue my degree and graduated from St. Mary of the Woods in 2010. Taught kindergarten and a preschool Title I director position in Edinburgh, Indiana, before I moved back to my hometown of Clay City in 2016. And at that point, I started teaching at Sullivan Elementary as special ed teacher there. On a personal note, I just celebrated my 25th wedding anniversary this month. Proud mom of three kids, ages 18, 13, and 9. And advocating for students with special needs has been near and dear to my heart since our oldest son was diagnosed with a disability as a toddler. Those experiences as a parent and as a teacher have really provided me with a unique perspective that helps me serve the students and families with compassion, hard work, and commitment. This year at Green Sullivan, I have encouraged our staff to focus on this quote by Judith Billings: "Change is the reality. Children are the priority, and collaboration is the strategy." My first 90 days as the director has been filled with several challenges and learning opportunities. And the biggest challenge that we've all faced is those ever-changing situations that are sponsored by COVID-19. I am proud of our staff who have truly collaborated and worked together tirelessly to meet the needs of our students, filling the gaps when we have paras or teachers on leave due to quarantine. So currently at Bloomfield, nearly 15% of the student population has an individual education plan or IEP. There are 34 students with a specific learning disability, 16 with an other health impairment, 14 with a developmental delay, 7 with an emotional disability, 6 with an intellectual disability, 3 with deaf or hard of hearing loss, 1 with blind or low vision, and 65 students with a speech or language impairment. Bloomfield currently has 7 students in the developmental preschool program hosted in White River Valley Elementary. We have 20 students of Greene County in the life skills program in grades 6 through 12 who are blessed to call Bloomfield Junior High, Senior High their home. We were excited to welcome back Kelly Cochran, who has 17 years of teaching experience as the lead teacher in the life skills program here in Bloomfield. Green Sullivan also employs 1 school psychologist, a speech language pathologist, an occupational therapist, a physical therapist, a job coach for our life after school program, and 9 paraprofessionals that are in your buildings making students the priority and collaborating together with your staff to meet their needs. We are dedicated to providing training and consultation to all staff members and administrators, and we know that in order to make a difference in the lives of children, we must continue to improve our practices through professional development and continued education. We're facilitating community partnerships to ensure the families have resources available as well to help children with disabilities. Most importantly, if you ever have any questions about what we provide or how we can help, I'm always available, as well as our staff. And we are just very thankful to have the opportunity to continue, that you continue to trust us with our special education services for your students. So thank you for having me.
All right. Got the superintendent's report here before we get to other business. And just want to go through a few things here. On food services, the USDA is now providing free meals through the end of the school year or until funds run out. But it sounds like there's going to be enough funds. So what a blessing to our families to have free meals in our cafeteria. Technology-wise, I know we added K through 6 one-to-one this year, and we were a little concerned for Derek. He was busy enough with 7 through 12 and adding K through 6, but we're excited to say it's kind of normalized, and he's able to have a reasonable amount of tickets and keep up at this point. During COVID, there's been an increase in cyber attacks. So we have in process, I think by December 1st, we want all staff to do a 2-step verification system, logging into their computers, just an extra layer of protection. So we're in process of that. We're in process of distributing T-Mobile hotspots for families that were identified as not having reliable internet. That process has started, and they're getting out there, and Derek and I tested them over fall break, and they do work, and they're effective. We have ordered 20 ViewSonic screens. They're kind of like smart boards, but better, or smart boards may argue that, but they offer more things for us, so we're going to get those hopefully soon, put those in the elementary classrooms with some training. And the smart board, there are some junior, senior high school teachers whose smart boards aren't working as well, and we're going to maybe replace some of those with the ones we're taking out in the elementary. So that's technology. Operations and maintenance. With our building project coming up, our cross-country course is going to be kind of, we won't be able to have the cross-country course that we've had. And so we've begun work. I had the cross-country coaches, Mr. Neal. We had an excavator out there, and he had his equipment out there. We thought this is the time to start mapping out our cross-country course. And so the cross-country coaches mapped it out, and we had the excavator out there that went through some of the woods so that some of the cross-country route will go through the woods. And it is a one loop. 5-kilometer cross-country course, which is very odd to have, which is usually you're doing, like here we did 4 loops. And I'm going to go out on a limb and say it's going to be one of the nicest courses in the state. So we're excited about the cross-country course. The South Complex soccer fields have been aerated and 2,500 pounds of fertilizer spread that was needed because the soil, it's very hard to grow grass out there because of the soil. So we've had to keep those fields nice. They needed to have to be fertilized and aerated. We also had some soil erosion out there that it's being taken care of, and I think it's finished now. A new sign for the tennis courts. We got new lockers in the C hallway that are in use as well. We also just received, it says here, pending delivery, we got it yesterday, a new Type A special purpose bus for the special needs, and it is here, and we're excited to have that. It's a very nice bus with a lift and harnesses within the seat for special needs students. Here at the central office, building projects moving forward and on track, and we have Winifred Architect here is going to do a presentation here in a little bit seeking for approval for design development. And so as far as the bonds and everything, we got those sold literally this week, and we're on track with everything with that, with the finances and the project. We did find out we have a State Board of Accounts audit on the horizon, so we're really excited about that.
Stacy's always thrilled.
Yeah. And then athletics, Mr. Dean shared some highlights of the success of our fall teams. I won't go say anything about that, but a new baseball scoreboard has arrived, new batting cage has been ordered, and all basketball teams and winter sports have elementary through high school have begun practice except for the high school boys. So a little summary there from the superintendent. And now we're ready, sorry, I jump into other business. Presentation of our design development by KRM, Winifred Williams.
All right, welcome everybody. This is a kind of a recap of the project so far. And I think some of these slides you've seen before, but sometimes it's been, I think it's been about 2 months since we presented last. But we basically had a list of priorities. You have a laundry list of things that you'd like to see here, but what we try to do is get priorities on those. This is kind of a top-down look at your first floor plan. And we're going to be doing a lot of furniture and finishes in your elementary wings. And right there in the elementary office, we're going to be remodeling a lot of that area. And then you can see the yellow dots are really where secure entry points are going to go around. So we're going to be looking at every secure entry point, getting all those covered through this project. This upper level, we're going to do roof repair over the F wing is really the only place that we're doing roof work. Again, you can kind of see a myriad of yellow dots where secure entry points are going to be worked on, and kind of a, this is the remodel areas that we're going to be working on, and I've got some slides further down that go into those a little bit more. This slide kind of just shows you how complex your site is now. You got rolling hills here. They're beautiful when you drive, and I actually saw a rainbow as I came in, so.
You planned it.
You planned it, I know. I was like, right over your school. I was like, this is great.
Why can you left that on? You want to hit that switch over there?
So one of the things we're trying to really fix is the bus, the before and after school. And this is going to be your new site plan, if you will. And most of this is really going to be really taking a look at taking out the student parking that's there now and reworking it to have a really safe bus drop off and pick up for the school. And so you kind of see here the elementary drop off and pick up is going to stay the same, but for the buses, they're going to be lining about three spots deep right here, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and they're all going to go onto a safe sidewalk and then they're going to go up to the elementary or go up into the junior high or high school. So this is probably the change from what you saw before. So we're in what's called design development, where we have schematic, which we had, we wanted to have parallel parking here, and it just doesn't work with your site. We did many meetings with principal and superintendent to try to figure out the safest way that we can work this out without breaking the bank and without the loss of your parking over here for the visitors and for your high school students. Any questions about this? We still have to have a loading dock space for basically right out here for the kitchen. And then you can kind of see a red dot over here. We're not quite sure exactly where your relocating of your barn is, because right now with this remodel, it kind of goes into where your barn is right now. So that's going to have to move somewhere. And when we did this last week, it was here, but now we think it's in, it's at another place. Maybe just right across from the barn that's already there. We think it might be a better space. It was flat here. I guess we had some houses that you bought and tore down. And then you can see the other red space over here is this new entry for the high school and a new multi-purpose space for the school. Any questions on the site plan? So basically the buses will come down this road, the park right here, the students will load off, and then most likely this whole row will leave and exit out a single entry point, and then they can disperse left or right. It's kind of the movement of what the buses will be.
Now, Riegelman, wasn't it discussed that, you know, you got employees that park out here with their buses? Those buses, maybe having them stay to the inside when they come in the morning, those buses sit there all day?
No, what we've talked about, nothing's been decided. What we've talked about is to have them park in the back. You know, you got the bus running now, that other one's supposed to go across the street from there. Have a parking area back there for those.
Because there'll be about seven of them.
Yeah. So that's kind of what we're talking about. Yeah. Okay. But we really don't like the idea of them sitting there all day.
Okay.
That's just what we're talking about. Nothing's been decided.
Yeah. So the next phase we're going into is construction documents. And that's where we kind of figure out all the nitty-gritty details. And so one of them is, again, you kind of see here in a straight path. We don't want people racing down here. So we're going to put speed bumps and all kind of safety measures as much as possible, as well as your student spaces over here. So a lot of work is happening on your site plan. And you do have a difficult site plan, and that you have the nice hills. This is your high school addition. So you guys are going to get a brand new, awesome, school-inspiring, school-spirited type of entry point. You're going to enter into this space, and basically all this space over here is all the high school offices and counseling departments that are currently now, you have to hunt for them on the second floor. So they're going to be right there in the front. You're going to have a secure entry point as you come in here. A nice 20-foot wide hallway. It's going to be one of your widest hallways as you come in. It's going to be a great gathering space when we can gather, right? And then the media center gets just extended into that space. And then down here, you kind of see where it's a basketball court, just kind of showing us the outline of how big this space actually is. It's definitely going to pale in comparison to your high school gym. It's still going to be, you know, the crown jewel of everything. But this space is going to be a great flexible wood floor. So it can be used as a gym, but it can be used for, you know, plays and all kinds of sort of things. We got seating on one side. And what's going to be really neat is we got daylight coming in. It's kind of like this space is really nice during the day because you got natural light coming through. So a lot of gyms don't have that. We're going to add that to this gym. That's going to add to that multi-functional type space. So we got lights here, and we got windows down here as well, too. Any questions about this? It's really fuzzy. I apologize. But in your board packets, I believe you have the details of everything. And that you kind of see where it's located here. The other area of remodel is what we're doing is at the elementary entry. And this really hasn't changed from the last time you saw it, except for we're giving the nurse their own space, which is basically in the old former boardroom, and basically the whole space is going to become a nurse space, which is really needed, especially in this time. You kind of see we got 4 beds that can be located here along this wall. She gets, you know, private restroom for the students and washer and dryer and just a space for 2 people to work. It's going to be really great. And it's kind of centrally located, and if a student is sick, they can walk directly outside at that point. Any questions about this?
What's in that bottom corner?
This space?
I guess it's just the outside space.
Yeah, this is where your flag is.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this is outdoor space. So this is the walk, as you walk into the elementary. This is the superintendent's entrance now, and that's the elementary entry.
And that's covered, right?
Yes, that is our hope, that it is covered.
Remind me of Elmer. Hey, I'm just going by the pictures, man.
Pictures
that they were covered.
At some point, there's going to have to be some hard decisions.
Or principals out there with umbrellas, what do you think?
Hey, I'm trying. I made you walk in with me yesterday or this morning. I was really pitching it then.
Your junior high gets, we're trying to fix the ADA issue. I mean, it's not a huge lift, but it's like 6 inches here, 6 inches there. It adds up to being difficult if you're in junior high to get into the locker rooms. So we're remodeling that in the hopes to try to get rid of the giant bank of showers into more useful private restroom stalls there. And then basically where, and I don't know if you guys already know this or not, but like the high school office suite is going to become the central office suite, and so, which is great, it works out really nice. We're going to give you some more space for your IT, so we're kind of tearing down some walls and making that space a lot bigger and creating a break room for the high school teachers on that level into this space. So we're just basically just taking down a few walls, which is, that's a lot more cost effective than just adding a bunch of stuff. So we're going to have a nice new conference space for central office, the high school, and the elementary. So that's something you don't have right now. You basically have to all share, I think, the boardroom right now. Any questions about this space before we go on? These spaces? Your ag space needs a safe interior access. And so what we're creating here is a kind of a throughway. This is right where your ROTC space is right now, into a kind of a storage room, and we're going to open that up, and we're going to have a safe ADA access to your ag space that you don't have now. They have to walk outside. And this is the fun part where you get to see exterior and what it looks like. So this is becoming your new entry point into your high school. It looks better on my screen.
You're going to start sleeping down. There you go.
A little better?
Yeah, I think so. So this is your high school gym wall right here. And then this is the new high school offices. And then that nice wide hallway that I talked about before, 20-foot wide hallway, is actually going to get some natural light coming in. And this is the, you know, the glass I was telling you about that goes into that new multi-purpose space. You're going to be able to see, you know, activity, you know, at night, kids playing in there is going to be a lot of fun. You can kind of see that the school is alive at night as well. And some school spirit, some stuff we could put on there. And another view from the road. Kind of more of a, there, you won't have all these lines. That's just the way our drawings. Your road won't be stepped. And another view, like if you're in the student parking, and you're getting off the bus, this is what you're going to see. You're going to be able to see to come up here. I could see a lot of students getting picked up, you know, after school practice around that entry. And then this is a shot of the interior. This is something new that you haven't seen before. But again, this is like if you're inside this new high school entry point, when you walk in, and we got an opportunity to have lots of school spirit along here.
That's a 20-foot hallway.
Yeah. So off to your left, this is like if you've walked in, you've gone through this main secure doors, you're able to see into the main office here. Maybe there's announcements. And then one of the things we really wanted to highlight was your career space. And so that has its own entry point right from the hallway.
Can we save some money by making the principal's office smaller?
I don't think
we'd really need it that nice. That's real pretty.
Yeah, I think it's pretty simple that it can change over time. You know, a nice red line here, maybe some, again, what these graphics actually are going to be right here, we're still working on all that. So that's part of the construction documents, is really like, what is the actual color of this wall? Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe it'll change. And then your media center is at the far end of it as well. So the other picture I have is like, if you turned over and you're entering into the multi-purpose gym, and whether this is called this or it's, you know, you have a name for the gym, that can go here. But again, it's this opportunity to have like some gathering space here. You know, I could see lots of like maybe some tables and chairs here, or maybe that's where you have like bake sales. I mean, that's really what adds to the multi-purpose, is not only the space, but the space directly outside of it. We've all been through crowded narrow hallways into a great space. You really need to have both the space in the hallway match the space inside the space. So
someone proposed calling it the nest. But
the nest.
Oh, yeah.
So I went to Ball State, so we had all those phrases, right? And then this is your cover.
That looks covered
to me.
It's really nice. You have to walk in one morning and pouring down rain.
It was one of the things on the discussion for saving money, but that's why he keeps pushing for it.
What principal smell?
My wife wouldn't let me in the house first time.
Yeah. Right? Why, you don't get it.
Yeah. Almost. A good portion out. It just costs more money to do all that kind of, but it's a good way. Yeah, I don't know the exact dimensions. I get that for you guys there. But one of the things we wanted to do is, like, you know, the high school's getting a nice, great entryway, kind of, I guess, jazzing up the elementary, you know, school spirit for that. Whether we had some discussion of what kind of cardinal actually goes there, you know, it looks kind of stagnant. Maybe Cardinator. We do another one. Cardinator. But this would be an independent structure that would just be there. You can, one of the things that we're talking about is, we hope that we can get everything in the project. There's always, you just don't know what the bidding market is actually going to be like. So one of the things you're doing is we're having alternates.
Well, I think for me personally, the critical element on that area right there is probably the grading that you do to fix the water problems that we have right now.
Correct. Yes, and what we're basically
priority over there.
Yeah, we're basically going to be creating a, right now you have no curb, so it's flat and it goes right in the grass and all the water goes to the lowest point, which is your doors. What we're adding is a sidewalk and a curb cut the whole way along there. So your drainage problems will,
good.
That and on your east end into the elementary, into the E-wing is going to get worked on as well. And then all the site work that you saw earlier in the presentation is going to be worked on as well. So, any questions?
What was the plan for in here? I know something was said about this space here. What did they come up with in here?
Yeah, so right here, like in this room?
Yeah, I have the cafeteria. They discussed eventually about taking that out. I didn't know.
Well, that was one of the things that we had talked about earlier in schematics. So that was like 2 months ago. So basically, we're actually not touching anything in this space. So it's really just the front entry, the ag space, the elementary, classrooms, and the front entry.
But we were improving our lunch area inside. The kitchen was still
upgraded. That has been removed from the project as of right now because of the expense that it is. We are going to replace the dish machine, so you will get a brand new dish machine within this project.
Okay.
And I know that is a change, and that a lot of it has to do with the budget. And it's one of those things, we had a really hard, difficult discussion a couple weeks ago, trying to figure out what's in and what's out. And again, one of the things, it's like, what's the priorities? And that's one of the things that we said we can, we have actually a plan. So our team has done a whole layout. We have a whole plan for what can happen in the food service area and pricing to everything. So like in the future, you know exactly what you can do and what the cost might be.
Yeah, I know that equipment's getting pretty run down in there.
It is. Yeah. It is. It's definitely one of a difficult, it's a difficult one to say no to. But we're excited, you know. So basically the next steps are for you guys to approve the design as it is right now, and then we'll move forward in construction documents. It's going to take us throughout the holidays into the end of January, and then it goes out to bid February, so that you guys are going to start construction as early as March, April next year. I think the next time we talk with you, we haven't really worked out the phasing and how this is going to impact the school. So now that we know the scope, that's really the next step, is understanding the phasing of it.
I have a question. Can you clarify what you said about the elementary classrooms? Were they going to be remodeled? Like, we were talking about cabinets and flooring and things.
Yeah. So what's going to happen in the elementary classrooms is new flooring, painted walls, and the cabinetry that they have now will be taken out and something, and will be replaced one for one with new casework that fits the needs of the teachers. We're also trying to provide more storage. So like in the F wing, there's these little cubbies. We're gonna actually close those off, put a door on them, and those are gonna become teacher storage spaces. And in the E wing, we're gonna remodel the restrooms that are in there. So that's kind of unique to that elementary wing. And so that's gonna get new paint and new flooring in the restrooms. So a refresh of that space. One of the things that we'd really like to do, and it gets one of those alternate things, is to put cubbies in. We really wanna get those in, but it really separates the students' belongings versus just a hook right next to another belonging. So that's in the design right now. So that's the scope of it. And then it's the hope to get furniture as well, but buying of the furniture won't happen until after our project is bid. It's one of those things you don't have to buy until later. Does that answer your question?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Was it in the plans to replace a lot of the furniture in the high school too, the chairs and stuff, their desk?
Right now it is not.
Okay.
Yeah. Any other questions? These are good questions. If you have any other, send them to Dr. Lehman, yeah. Right?
Yep. There is, you talked about the add-ons and deletions. I've just went through this where I came from. There's just hard decisions. I mean, it's just, you can't do everything you want to do, unfortunately, even for $10 million, so, you know. But things are cost more than you realize sometimes. So we got a whole team of people trying to make those decisions along with their advice as well. Of course, we hope the bids come out way lower and we can do add-ons. They come higher, we have to make even tougher decisions. And so that's why we were joking with Mike about his overhang. That was one that was pretty expensive and something maybe we could do later if we can't fit it in this one. But we have to think, it's just, we're in that process right now, and this is where we've landed as of now. So. But yeah, we're looking for a motion to approval for the design development where we're currently at, so they can start moving forward with the construction bidding, or not bidding, the construction...
Documents.
Okay, we have a recommendation to approve. Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to be approved.
Rich, okay, do we have a second?
I'll second it.
Lynn, second. All in favor? Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Other business, 5B, tentative agreement for the 2020-2021 collective bargaining agreement between Bloomfield School District and Bloomfield Teachers Association.
Yes, we had collective bargaining a couple weeks ago, and we came to a tentative agreement, and that tentative agreement is supposed to be, we've had that posted for 72 hours before this meeting, and there's no action needed at this meeting, but we can allow for public comment, and we needed to post the TA within 72 hours. And you have been given the details of that. I will not go through that since it's been on our website, and you have it in your packet. Anybody have any questions on that? Any public comment on the tentative agreement with the teachers? Next week, we'll have to have a special board meeting for the ratification of that. We'll have that public notice 72 hours before that meeting, and comments can be taken at that point as well. And that will be the official vote to accept the collective bargaining agreement next Thursday.
Good. Agenda item 5C.
All right. Through discussion with our elementary secretaries and our principal, Mr. Riggleman, it has been determined that we would like to increase our elementary halftime secretary position to full-time. Right now it's 29 and a half hours. We'd like to extend that to 37 and a half hours. Rescinda has retired, and we're going to post that position, and we feel it is needed to make that a full-time position. So requesting approval, permission for that.
Okay. We have a recommendation to approve. Do I have a motion? Katie, do we have a second?
I'll second.
Terry Neighbors, okay. All in favor? All right, thank you. Agenda item 5D.
All right, we're looking for permission to sell or dispose of surplus equipment. You saw the list in there, 16 desktop computers, printers, monitors, basically mostly computer equipment, and three smart boards that are end of life. Derek's very thankful that we got these laptops this year, and he was spending an inordinate amount of time fixing those end-of-life desktops, and we now have laptops, and we're just asking for to make those surplus items.
Okay. We have a recommendation.
Can I ask a question? Just to verify on that, you said these are IT assets, and you're going to be getting rid of those. Sanitizing all of this, make sure there's no PII or...
Yeah, the company that recycles them for us does all that.
Okay, great.
And they provide documentation that's... Yeah, they provide documentation, everything has been completed.
Good.
Do we have a recommendation, or we have a recommendation, do I have a motion to approve?
I'll motion that we approve.
Okay, do I have a second? No. Chris, thank you. All in favor? All right, thank you. Agenda item 6, public comment regarding agenda items.
There were none,
thank you. Okay, and board member comments and items for future agendas. All right, and future board meetings, we will have a special meeting next Thursday at 7 p.m. And then the November meeting is, I didn't write that down, November the 19th.
It's a week sooner than normal, unless you guys want to meet on Thanksgiving.
I'd like to have it as an option.
And then same thing in December, it'll be a week sooner because of Christmas.
Okay. All right then, at this time, we'll adjourn the meeting. Thank you very much.